Jeremy got into trouble last year for suggesting all lorry drivers murder prostitutes with hammers. I can see both sides. Sure, he shouldn't have said it, but then they shouldn't be murdering prostitutes with hammers. OK. Sean, Jeremy, James, what'd you like the look of?
The runners.
OK. Well, you've chosen the marathon runners. Here's a clip to illustrate the question. Have a look at this.
After more than 140 miles, it's come down to less than 100 feet. To that damn line. Yards behind, her stalker appears. It's Wendy Ingram. Their bodies were obliterated, but the spirit held firm. Welch and Ingram crawling in a battle for fourth place.
They did look like a giraffe that had just been born. Just incredible.
Well, what I didn't understand, why there was people just passing them going, I've just done the same thing, love, what are you being mental for?
OK, your question is... More patients in accident and emergency have injured themselves through exercise than alcohol.
Yes, definitely, without a question or shadow of doubt.
I injured myself throwing... I was in a park, there was a football up a tree. I picked up a cricket stump. You know, when you throw a stump into a tree and it bounces
around. Yeah, yeah, throwing a stump into a tree. Yeah. What do you think I do on my days off?
And because it was a real sunny day, I couldn't see, like, where it was in the sun and stuff, and it came back and hit me, and everyone went... You know when you try and sort of style it out like you meant it, sort of thing?
He meant it.
You always did that.
You
were unlikely they meant to do that.
Yeah. I actually had a groin strain playing 10-pin bowling.
You've got David's attention.
Yeah.
Tell him more about
the
pins.
Where did it hurt?
Just there. Well, no, much. It was much. It was more of a calf strain. Yeah, 10-pin. I took my little brother 10-pin bowling, and you think, ah, how hard can it be? It'll be all right. And you go for it, and you pick up the heaviest ball, and I went for it, and just pulled the old groin, and I actually had to go to the doctors the next day, and I paid for 3 games. That was the thing that really hurt.
How many people here have injured themselves drinking?
Yeah, loads.
What have you ever injured yourself with drinking?
Fallen down. I got my jaw broken.
By who?
Well, the bloke who ran the pub.
Technically not a drinking injury, that's more a violence related thing.
Yeah, but I wouldn't have been there if I had been drinking. No. I wouldn't have been singing that song.
More patients in accident and emergency have injured themselves through exercise than alcohol. Is it true or false?
Whenever you go to casualty, you always see kids with, like, cricket balls sticking out their heads and stuff, so it's...
always.
More than you see piss heads, yeah.
OK, so you're going for truth, you're going for...
Oh, well, we'll go for false, then why not?
OK, I can tell you the answer is false. Less than 1% of patients in A&E have injured themselves exercising, but an incredible 40% of A&E patients have injured themselves because of alcohol. It's a pain in the arse waiting in A&E. That's because you've got a Hoover stuck up there. So, at the end of that round, it's 2 points for Sean's team and 5 points for Jason's team.
Oh.
And the winner is the name of our final round. Here is your first one. Top household convenience drivers would like in their car.
How about replacing the electric windows with sash windows?
And having a window box on the bonnet.
Yeah, it'd be nice, wouldn't it?
Lots of nice flowers.
Yeah, grow your own.
Yeah.
Using your mobiles illegal, what about a landline?
That's a great idea.
Nice, thank you.
An ejector seat like the one I've got in my bedroom.
You've got an ejector seat in the bedroom?
Yeah, I say it'll be very nice, but off you go. But I reckon a fridge.
That's the right answer.
Fridge. Yeah.
That's basically what an ice cream van is, though.
It's an ice cream van.
You're saying it. What am I saying?
Yes, the top household convenience drivers would like in their car is a fridge. You can get a car with a fridge and a TV and a sink. It's called a caravan, and if you buy one, he'll blow it up. OK, next one. Biggest cause of anger in Britain.
I tell you what winds me up. Oh, it makes me absolutely... You know when it's a windy day and it's raining and your umbrella ends up going like that?
Ooh.
Is it badly organised anger management classes?
It is when somebody comes out of a petrol station and then takes 15 minutes to get out of your way. You were talking about being allowed to punch people in the back of the head for dawdling. I would rake them with machine gun fire if I were What do they do for the next 15 minutes before moving away?
Normally, I think they're sitting there going, that Clarkson's behind me. Yeah. Biggest cause of anger in Britain.
Is it the ratio of steak to kidney in most steak and kidney pies? Yeah. Very rarely do they get it right. You always go, oh, that's two kidneys. Or you go, where's the kidney? I didn't buy a steak pie. And then the wind picks up and your umbrella goes, you go, what a day!
OK, so, biggest cause of anger in Britain?
Is it when you're in a supermarket and you've bought loads of shopping and the woman says, do you want some bags? And you're like, what? You know, I've got clown's trousers, I'll just whack it in my pocket.
It's a very British thing.
Queuing! People jumping the queue!
Oh, I know!
Correct.
Oh, no, it's that.
Yes, the biggest cause of anger in Britain is queue jumping. Here's a tip. If you're in the supermarket and there's a massive queue and you've only got a few items, get to the back, no one cares. Well, that sound tells me it's the end of the round and the end of the show, which means the final scores are Sean, Jeremy and James have a pitiful 2 points. Jason, David and Holly have won with 7 points. Thanks to all our panellists, our wonderful studio audience and to all of you for watching at home. That's it from us. Good night.
So Sophia's leaving the house.